surface once again in the glow of the atom.
What comes after the end? I don't know. Neither did they. They were just an army engineer battalion, constructing roads and bridges deep in the middle of the Arizona nowhere. They didn't know why Armageddon had come. They'd heard radio chatter about an attack on some space-based missile platform. But who had attacked it, or why? No one knew. What they did know is that the politicians and the generals had finally ended the world. Now, everything was gone. They took over a federal prison for a fort, kicked out the convicts, got busy starting from scratch. Maybe it was an act of mercy. Maybe they figured that the prisoners would die out in the harsh new world. Whichever, it came back to bite the engineers in the ass. Cultists, criminals, cannibals. They've been living with the fallout ever since. Good people had survived too, called for help in the night. And those engineers, those common soldiers, could not stand by and see them die. So they came out of their fort, and they helped the survivors defend their homes. And for that, they earned a new name, a proud name, the Desert Rangers. Now, Rangers, I know at times, it seems our cause is hopeless. And I know it's hard to say goodbye to a brother in arms. But I want you to know something else. That no Ranger who dies in the line of duty will ever be forgotten. Nor will he have ever died in vain or unavenged. Thank you, recruits.
I appreciate you coming to Captain Ace's retirement party when you hardly knew the man. Appropriate, too, seeing as how investigating his death will be your first duty as a Desert Ranger. Ace had been trying to locate a faint radio signal, which has lately been giving us cause for concern. We gave him 3 repeater units and sent him to hook him up to 3 remote radio towers. This would have allowed us to get a fix on the signal. But sadly, Ace was murdered by unknown assailants right after hooking up the first tower, and his logbook and the last 2 repeater units were stolen. Don't know, but it wasn't on Ace's person when he was found. Look for it. It might have some clues as to his death. I'll give you the locations of the towers once you have the repeaters in hand. When you get back to the Citadel, talk to our radio expert, Wade Woodson, if you want to know more about the technical details. All I know is the repeaters will upgrade the towers and allow us to zero in on the mystery signal. The voice on those broadcasts disturbed me greatly. It talked crazy talk about a future where man and machine would be one. Worse, it talked about us, the Desert Rangers, specifically. It said it was coming for us. Yeah, I know. You've hardly found your feet with us, and here I am sending you on a mission that already got one Ranger killed. Well, I wish I had another option, but the Desert Rangers are spread a little thin right now. Ranger teams Abel and Charlie are out west trying to stop a range war out there from becoming straight-up genocide. And Team Baker is up north looking for a way through the radiation. The mission is this: search the area where Ace's body was found and do your best to recover his logbook and the repeater units. Then call in your report. Ace's death must be avenged, and it will be. But finding the signal he died trying to track down is just as important. It's about a day's walk east from here. I'll mark it on your map. There you go. Yes, call in on your radio. Your radio is your lifeline to Ranger Citadel. We'll be calling you with alerts and updates on your current missions and sending you new missions when we receive distress calls. As Rangers, it is your sworn duty to respond to those calls. Once you prove yourself, the Citadel will be your new home. Consider this mission the final test of your training. If you succeed, you are welcome within our walls. If you fail, then you aren't cut out to be a Desert Ranger, and we won't let you in. Using logic on me, eh? Smartass. Logic and observation will change some folks' minds, and you can catch people in lies that way. But sometime, it only makes them mad, so be careful. In this case, you're right. I should let you in. But I got a feeling about you 4. You got depths you don't even know you have, and it's gonna take adversity to tap them. Maybe. Good luck out there, recruits.
Echo 1, mind picking up that can over there for me? Think there's some water in there. He headbutted you, right in the butt! Did you actually think I was serious about wanting that can? I just wanted the goat to hit you in the ass.
Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Roger, Echo 1. Just making sure your radio is working. I'll be your dispatcher from here on out. I also wanted to give you a little heads up on your water situation. If you've all got full canteens, you should have enough water to reach the place where Ace died with plenty to spare. Remember, your main priority is to recover the repeater units Ace was carrying. Once you've got the devices, you'll be headed to Ag Center and Highpool to install them. But we'll talk about that after you acquire the repeaters. Until now, Woodson's been our dispatcher. But Ace's death made me realize I've spent too many years in my office, walled off from the world and how it's changing. I need to know what's going on out there, and I figure the best way to do that is to start listening to the people's problems. Don't let that make you self-conscious or nothing. It is vital that all teams stay in radio contact with me here at the base. We get distress calls from all over our jurisdiction and sometimes beyond. 10-4 Echo 1, carry on. Ranger.
Thank you. Thank you.
Roger that, Echo One. When you reach the area where Ace's body was found, give it a good going over. The folks that picked him up said it looked like he crawled there. Maybe you can find some tracks leading to where he was attacked. Copy? 10-4, Echo One, and check in immediately with any new info.
Yard, you gotta pay. 15 scrap, or we'll break your faces. And my dog will eat your corpses. You're insane. What the hell is wrong with you? Just go on through, you sick bastard.
Step off.
Well, let me tell you, Matthias' law, friends. Matthias' law is vengeance. And soon, Matthias' law will stretch all the way to Arizona and kill those so-called upholders of justice. Desert Rangers.
21, go ahead. Got an up, what? Well, I'll be goddamned. We haven't seen any synthetics around for almost 15 years. We better get a closer look at the tech. Mir Captain might be able to tell us where it came from. That is Mir Captain's fancy word for smart robots. She calls them synthetic life forms, or synths. Basically, any robot that can think for itself falls into the synth category. Plain old robots are dangerous enough. Ones that think for themselves are a nightmare. Good, but our priority is still those repeaters. Now that you have them, I'm sending you on to complete Ace's mission, which was to attach him to the most powerful towers in Arizona. Hyphool is at the most southern and eastern corner of our jurisdiction. They're a vital part of the stable society we've been trying to build here in Arizona. They provide Team Mayor Vikstrom there about using their tower. He knows you're coming. Ag Center is due south of Ranger Citadel and very important to what we're trying to achieve. The researchers there are developing hardier plants and animals that will thrive in the harsh conditions of the waste. Talk to Matt Forrestal about hooking up to their radio dish. Used to be one of us. Now he runs things down there. Matt's good people. They built their tower on top of an old crane. A bit unorthodox, but it gets great reception. Used to be part of an old satellite relay system, from what Woodson tells me. Strongest transmitter in Arizona. Roger, Echo One. Ranger Command out. Copy, Echo One. Echo One, I'm happy to see several members. Congratulations, Echo One. Give me up. Thank you.
SOS! SOS! Is anybody out there? This is Hypool. We are under attack. I repeat, we are under attack. Raiders with mortars and explosives are blasting our walls. If anybody can hear this, come at once. Don't know how long we can hold up.
Ag Center, this is Citadel Base. Can you repeat? Did you say the plants were attacking?
Yes, goddammit, the plants! Something's gone wrong with them! The door! They're breaking down the door! Fall back! Fall back!
Ranger Team Echo, this is Ranger Command. Come in. Did you copy those distress calls from Hypool and Ag Center? Over. Roger that. Listen, Echo One, I have no one else in the area and no further intel at this time. Suspicious, isn't it, Echo One? Like someone's monitoring our transmissions. 10-4, Echo One. Roger, Echo One. Now listen, I want you to deal with the emergency situation first, before proceeding to the antenna. Roger, Echo One. Advise when complete. Ranger Command out.
Damn, stop! Clean up! Reservoir! Sound off! Give me the bad news!
Damn, stop reporting. Got some jackass shooting mortars at us. Can't hit. Can't hit shit. But he's setting a lot of fires.
Plane op reporting. Some jokers are slamming charges at the base of the wall. It looks like they're trying to take down the crate. Their leader, Chip, he's got a jackhammer for an arm.
A what? A jackhammer? Damn, freaks get crazier every year.
Reservoir checking in. A lot of damage back here. Damn tank is leaking like shit.
This is Kate down in the tunnel. Yeah. Irrigation is about to go. Too much pressure in the pipe.
I'm
trying to keep it off, but I need more hands.
No can do, Kate. Can't spare the men. These junkyard motherfuckers are about to come over the wall.
lost at day four. We've already got RSM troops on site. Call them.
I've been calling. They're not responding.
God damn it. All right. Didn't activate. Now stop calling. I got other shit going on. Copy Echo One. This is Ranger Command. Copy Echo One. Appreciate. Thank you. Copy, Echo One. This is Echo One. Congratulations, Echo One. Echo One. Echo One. Congratulations, Echo One.
Thank you. Heads up below! Box coming down! Hop in. We'll bring you up. Well, all right, McNamara. Good job. Wait a minute. You're not McNamara. Who the... Rangers? Rangers? Woohoo! Rangers! Our saviors! Well, I guess I gotta thank you for taking care of these clowns. Though you could have got here before they wrecked our irrigation system and killed our mayor. You gonna go finish them off now? Or are you just here for our radio tower like you told Mayor Vikström? Huh? Nobody. You wouldn't know him. Okay. No need to get rough. You know, you Rangers aren't the only game in town. We haven't seen you for nigh on a year, and the Red Scorpions show up when we call them. Hey, they're closer than you. They don't try to solve problems by shooting little children. You say that, but I know the truth. You just stay away from our kids, Rangers. They're all we got in this shitty world. I won't warn you twice. Not all of them, and the rest of them will be back for a reckoning. That'll be the end of us, unless you or the Red Scorpions take them out first. Personally. Those wreckers couldn't hit what they were aiming at if their lives depended on it. But they got in a lucky shot yesterday and shot Mayor Vikström when they was aiming at me. I've had to step in as temporary commander now Vikström's gone. But I aim to hold a vote and make it official as soon as things calm down. You still think the Rangers are the only ones who can deliver justice in this world? Gonna have a show of hands in the town square once we get these wreckers dealt with and the irrigation fixed. Kate Preston thinks she's a shoe-in, but I don't know, maybe nothing. Kate Preston says a wrecking crew bomb smashed some valves and it's leaking like a sieve. She thinks she's got the answer to everything. She thinks she's smarter than everybody else. Well, she's got the same problem the Rangers do. Call themselves the Wrecking Crew. Stupid name. But then they all have stupid names. I've seen a lot of freaks come out of the waste in my time, but I've never seen anything like her before. She had an arm like a jackhammer. Our local Sawbones. Me and the doc don't see eye to eye on a lot of things. Never mind about that, Rangers. It's not your business. I'm surprised you haven't heard of them, you being the law around here. They've been around for a year or so. Only mobile junkyard I've ever seen. Anyhow, they fucked us up proper. Not only did they kill the mayor and burn down our spring crop, but apparently one of their bombs smashed our irrigation system, too. After your history with us, you're damn right we got a problem with you. I guess old Snake ain't too keen to teach his new recruits the truth about the Rangers' glorious past. Well, let me fill you in. 15 years ago, you fuckers came out here and shot a little orphan boy's dog. And then you shot the little orphan boy. Well, after that, Highpool only accepted Ranger protection because there was nobody else to turn to. Well, are we? You'd think the Rangers would keep a better eye on the place that provides them with the most of their water. The Rangers don't want to protect us anymore. The Scorpions are thirsty, too. Bobby's where the Rangers can't hurt him anymore. I visit his grave every day. And Rex's, too. He's buried right over there. Right next to Bobby. Huh. I thought as much. Rangers always think of themselves first. But we got an antenna up on the crane. But if you want to use it, you'll have to get it back online.
Go on, then. Remind us why we agreed to your protection.